everybody, it's Maddie Sofia from NPR and Joe's Big Idea, and we are here at the Smithsonian Conservation Biology Institute finding out what it takes to save the Maine wolf.
Known for the characteristic mane on their necks, the maned wolf of South America is nearly endangered. This is Dr. Nutrin Songsison. She's an expert in the reproductive biology of Maine wolves here in Front Royal, Virginia.
What's the deal with Maine wolves?
Oh my God, they are so cool. You know, we call them fox on stilts.
Fox on stilts.
People call them wolves, but they're not really wolves. When you're looking at the canid family, they're very unique species. We estimate there's about 20,000 of them left, but mostly living in the grassland habitat in Brazil. But the reason that we need to start paying attention to this guy now is because the habitat is gone. 80% of these grassland already disappeared.
Wow.
And only 5% of those natural habitat remaining is protected.
That's where Nooch comes in. She's breeding an insurance or backup population of maned wolves that can be reintroduced to their natural habitat if the wild populations die off.
What is your favorite thing about the maned wolf?
The smell.
For our viewers at home, it is not a good smell.
It is good
no,
smell.
It smells like skunks.
A little bit.
When you were growing up, did you think you were going to be a scientist?
I grew up in Bangkok, Thailand. When I was a little girl, I wanted to be a veterinarian because my father also a veterinarian. Mm-hmm. So I want to save animals. I want to work with animals. Then when I went to vet school, and then I said, oh, I want to be a scientist too. Merging the two worlds that I love.
You want a meatball? Fish? You want a grape? What do you want? I'm going to just, so I just launch it in her direction. Okay. Varsity softball. So Nooch.
Yes.
This is where the reproductive magic happens.
Yes.
This is your
the
lab.
Place. It is the place, yes.
Have you developed wolf tinder? What's going on?
For the matchmaking aspect, so what we have is that we have a list of male wolves and female wolves that will have their value that attached to them based on their genetic.
They have a value?
Yes.
These values are based on how genetically different or unrelated the wolf is to other wolves. The less related they are, the better. That's because genetic diversity in a population helps a species survive. Remember our buddies Finn and Avara? Nooch considered their genetics, as well as their age and health, to match them up. But breeding Maine wolves isn't as easy as just putting two wolves together.
They are seasonal breeders, meaning that they only breed a certain time of the year, and then one time they only have 2 to 3 days that they will breed a year.
That makes it hard for you to help build an insurance population.
I know that why we need to develop multiple tools that we can use to, you know, all sort of situation.
Have you tried, like, playing boys to men softly, maybe a bottle of wine? You add some skunk smell around, you know, maybe Finn needs a haircut. You know, you ever thought about that?
That's why Nooch and her team are trying to develop new techniques to help breed Maine wolves. Nooch's lab collaborated with Cornell University to perform the first successful in vitro fertilization in domestic dogs. Nooch even adopted one of the IVF puppies. Now, they are trying to adapt IVF techniques for the maned wolf. But until then, we'll just have to rely on the whims of romance.
Hey, Maddie.
Oh, hey, Adam.
What was the favorite thing that you learned while making this video?
Oh, the glitter poop.
Glitter poop?
Yeah, so to determine the digestive health of all these different wolves, they put different colored glitter in their food bowls.
Oh, okay.
So when they poop, it's glittery.
All right.
And they're like, oh, Finn has blue poop.
Okay. Well, that's the kind of sparkly fact that you can learn from Skunk Bear, NPR's science show. Please subscribe to our channel right here.
And you can watch the last episode of Maddie About Science right here.